did I get a 521 on my MCAT 3 days before starting my last finals of undergrad while taking a full course load of biomedical engineering classes? Great question. I would love to tell you. My name is Emily Boland with MCAT Mastery, and this is my story. I had never really considered medicine as an avenue I could pursue until I was halfway through college, and it was kind of slapping me in the face that this is what I wanted to work on. And so at this point, I'm 20 years old. I have literally only half of my college journey left, and I've never looked at a list of pre-med requisites or what is covered on the MCAT. Thankfully, I was studying biomedical engineering, so good news! A lot of the same material is covered in biomedical engineering. A lot of the prereqs were already covered. Bad news, not all of them were. I had a lot of extra classes I had to fit in while I was still in school, and I decided to condense everything into 3 semesters and a little bit of a summer, so that way I could take the MCAT during my 4th semester. That was important to me because I only wanted to take 1 gap year, and I knew I needed a score by the summer so I could get my application in and be competitive on the timeline. Here I am halfway through my 4th year of college, and I've finally taken all the classes I need to understand all the material that's gonna be tested. And I took that winter break, and I took this set of books I was studying from, and I went through the content really in depth. I tried to understand what was gonna be on the test and the structure of the test. Then the semester started back up, and I took a pause on all of my MCAT studying. I took the time to instead focus on my coursework, try to condense as much of the work from the whole semester as I could down into the first half of it, and free up the second half of the semester specifically for studying. It was an approach that ended up working for me. And when I got done with spring break, I jumped into MCAT studying full force. I took a full-length practice test every single Friday, and then I used the results of that test to redirect my studying for the next week. What topics should I cover? What mistakes am I making? What sections am I just kind of zoning out on? I spent 5 of the next 6 days working on those skills, reviewing that content, doing what I could to increase my score, and then I took that 6th day and I rested, because rest days are important. You are doing hard work and you deserve a rest day. Do not forget it. While taking those practice tests, my score went from a 507, that was my lowest full-length practice test score, up to a 521. I only had 7 weeks to do it in, and I made it work, and there was a lot I had to learn to make that jump. My vision for what was on the MCAT was wrong. I had thought that it was a test where you needed to learn and understand the content, and you needed to practice the content, and that was it. But I learned that's really only half the test. The other half of the test is learning how to create the habits, environment, the mental state for you to be able to succeed, not just in studying for this test, but in everything you want to do in medicine and in everything you want to do with your career. In order to get in that right mindset, there were 5 key things I learned. The first thing I learned was to unlearn some of the bad habits I picked up in college. One of these is my school's kind of unofficial motto for undergrad. It was work hard, play hard. A lot of fun, but not very useful. The MCAT needs the opposite thing. You need to work hard, rest hard. You are working your butt off trying to do well on this exam, and in order to actually succeed on it, you need to be in a good mental state. That is really, really important. If an athlete was training for a marathon, they wouldn't be staying up late, maybe eking in 5 hours of sleep where they can, subsisting off of Cheetos and whatever came out of the vending machine by the library. No, they'd be getting good sleep and they'd be fueling up properly, and you need to too, because this is a test of endurance. The second thing I learned, just like athletes, you need to work out properly, whatever that means for your body, whether it's stretching or running or going for a walk or doing an exercise class. You need to find something to make your body feel good, because when your body feels good, your mind feels good. You get those endorphins running, you clear your head, you tamp down some of that physical energy, and it helps you focus. And something that really helped me with item 3 I had to learn, how to wake up early. I'm not a morning person. Good news for people in medicine, there's plenty of shifts that work all hours of the clock. You don't have to be a morning person, but you do when you're taking this test. The test happens early. You have to get to the testing center even earlier than when you start taking your practice test. And so to get myself there, I relied on working out. I signed up for 2 5:45 a.m. spin classes a week, and they came with a $20 no-show fee. So you best know I was not about to skip a workout and lose $20. The workout was gonna help me, and that was money I wanted. The last thing that really was a mindset thing for me was how to focus for 7.5 hours straight. I don't know about you, I don't know a whole lot of people who can do that naturally, but it's something I really had to work on and I had to build up to. And it's one of my favorite things to work on with my students. I have this little stretch and breathing routine that I like to do to get myself focused and recentered, and I like to teach it to them when I notice their attention drifting. And that is one of the key things about learning how to focus for the whole test. It's not just knowing how to refocus when you're not paying attention, it's knowing how to notice when your attention slips in the first place, so you don't waste time letting yourself be zoning out in some other mental place. The last piece of the puzzle that had to come together for me was learning how to stay positive. There's this theory of motivation that I love called the expectancy value theory. And basically it tells you that how motivated you are to do something is the product of how much you value it, which I know all of you value this. You're here watching a video about someone telling you how they did well on the MCAT. You clearly want to do well on the MCAT. You value this. But it's also that value multiplied by your expectancy, how much you expect to succeed. That means you're more motivated to do the work when you think you're going to do well. It's important to stay positive. And everyone needs something different to stay positive. Everyone needs a different set of support, a different set of accountability, a different set of tools and techniques. And that is the number one thing that has been underlined with me as I am working with students. I knew coming into tutoring that I wanted to work on the MCAT because I've always held instructional roles. I love teaching. I love being able to pass on information that I have. And the MCAT, boy oh boy, did I learn a lot of information about the MCAT I was ready to share with other people. But it took me really working with a couple different students before I started to realize that the MCAT is challenging for everyone in a different way. Everyone is uniquely challenged by it. Everyone needs a unique solution. And that in itself can make it feel pretty isolating. Good news for you, you found MCAT Mastery. We're here, we're a whole community of people who want to support you and want to help you do well on the test and want to share with you the tips and tricks that we have to help you succeed. So, while you're here, why don't you click on the link below to see other videos from people like me sharing their strategies and tips to help you succeed. And if you thought I was fun and you want to work with me in the future and you want me to be a part of your MCAT journey, you can also click on the link below to sign up for some tutoring sessions with me. And lastly, I just want to welcome you guys to the club. I'm so happy you're here. Thank you for your time.